Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in to the tutorial on creating accessible PowerPoint presentations. This video is geared towards all APS employees creating documents for posting on the web and for distributing across the district. PowerPoint presentations are usually highly visual and packed full of information, which means a bit more attention will be needed to create presentations that not only win the day, but allow all users, no matter their ability, to be wowed by your scatterplots and KPIs. As mentioned in the other tutorials, you can find the accessibility checker in your toolbar. If you are using Office 365 or PowerPoint 2016 for Mac, you can find the accessibility checker here under the Review tab. If you are using PowerPoint in Windows, or if you are using an older version of PowerPoint, you'll find it by clicking on File, Info, Check for Issues, Check Accessibility. The dialog box will open to the right of your main window to indicate if there are fixes to be made or not. Okay, we're now ready to take a look at some of the common issues the accessibility checker is likely to find when creating PowerPoint presentations. One thing we tend to overlook in our presentation is how it might be seen from the back of the room, or by those who might print it out later as a resource. So, one great way to start off a project that can be admired for the ages is to select an accessible theme for your slideshow. Using textured or an uploaded image as a background should be avoided. It's just not a good practice. It just so happens that there is a built-in Office theme. Most are designed for accessibility using colors, contrasts, and fonts that are easy to read and designed so screen readers can more easily navigate the slide contents. However, and just an FYI, not all templates are ideal for accessibility. Steer away from the dark backgrounds and disorienting graphics by choosing something a bit more plain. To use the built-in Office theme, click on the Design tab and select Office Theme. People who may be blind or have low vision rely on slide titles to navigate PowerPoint slides. If someone is using a screen reader, they can quickly scan through a list of slide titles and go straight to the slide they want. To add a visible slide title, first, select the slide that you want to add a title to. Second, on the Home tab, click the Reset button. And third, type a unique name in the title box which appears. If you do not want the title you just created to be visible, click the selection pane located on the Arrange button menu on the Home tab. Next, click the eye icon next to the slide title text box to toggle its visibility. After adding titles and content to your slides, include some transitions between them. It helps those who have difficulty viewing the presentation know when the slide has changed. Go to the Transitions tab and choose a visual transition. Then, just to the right of that on the toolbar, click on the sound drop-down to choose a subtle tone that occurs on a mouse click. Click Apply to All. Before we move on, we just want to review alternative text and show how to add it. If you are using diagrams with images, charts, or standalone images and get the finger wag from the accessibility checker, just right-click on the image or blank space in the diagram to open a menu pane. Click on Format Object and choose the Size and Properties icon. There, you can add alt text. Audio and video are treated a little bit differently. Right-click on the video and choose Format Video from the menu. Another window will open and you can make size and brightness adjustments. In addition, you will need to add alt text by choosing the Size and Properties icon to the left of the video icon. Add a title, and in the description you can add a transcript of your video. For extra points, you can add the text to the notes section on that slide. About links, you'll want to avoid using link text such as click here or read more. Users will not understand where that link leads to. Instead, use a link text that gives readers an accurate description of the link destination. An easy way to check is to see if the link text would make sense when read by itself. Lastly, and as a friendly FYI, any video you create or link to will need to have subtitles. If you've posted your video to YouTube, you're in luck. YouTube has a captioning tool that will automatically caption your video. A transcript must be included for any audio content you might have in your presentation. That way, people who can't hear well will still be able to get the important information you are sharing. This should be a link to a Word or PDF document that can be downloaded by the user. Reading order highlights what's happening on your slides. You want to make sure that screen readers will read objects in the right order. Under tips in the accessibility checker, you might get results that a slide's reading order is out of whack. When you go to that slide, you'll be scratching your head because it most definitely looks to be in the right order with the title first and text second. However, screen readers read the slide in reverse, so just drag and drop the bottom object to the top. Titles will always be at the bottom. For more than two objects, you will have to simply reverse the stacking order as you did for just two objects. Here's a step-by-step review on setting the reading order. First, navigate to the toolbar and select the Home tab. Second, check Arrange and select the Selection Pane button. Thirdly, click and drag the items to rearrange the order. Remember, the item at the bottom of the list will be read first by the screen reader. Once you get the all clear from the accessibility checker, you can save your document as a PowerPoint or PDF and share your creation with the world. Now, turn to your left and ask that person next to you for a high five because you just created a presentation that complies with federal guidelines and has garnered you good karma points. That's all for this video. Be sure to check out the rest of the video series for even more tutorials on creating accessible content.